Hello, today I'm here with a new video and today I'm here with my October favorites. And this month has gone by so fast, like faster than any other month, and I haven't been home for like 2 weeks in October, so I guess that's why. So I don't have that many favorites because I have only wear makeup for like 2 days. No, 2 days, 2 weeks this month. Oh my god. But I have some favorites and yeah, okay, we just hop into this. So I want to start with a skincare thing, but also I don't know if this is like real skincare. This is from Pixi. It's the Glotion Day Dew. I have had this for such a long time, but I haven't used it. But in October, I tried to have this underneath my mineral foundation, and I love this. I have used it, I don't know how many times, but every time I've used my powder foundation or my mineral foundation, powder mineral foundation, I have used this underneath, and oh my god, I really really like this. I found it like in my stash with all other skincare things and I was like, I'm going to try this, and holy hell, this is so good. I really really love this. I don't want to use it only because it's really glowy, but okay, I can have some on my hands. You can see. Do you see this? I trying to watch the viewfinder if you can see this. I hope you can see it, but it gives like a really nice glow to the skin, and then with mineral foundation over, it shines through and it looks amazing. So I haven't even used like a highlighter when I have had this under my mineral foundation, and I love it. So if you want a dewy, nice product and it feels really good on the skin as well, try this. I don't know why I waited so long for open this. So okay, another face thing. I have started to use this Infinite Palette. Okay, I used this so much, but I have used this Andromeda and this Milky Way that I still haven't hit pan in. I am so close, I think. I have used these two so much in October. Like, it has been hard not to use these two, and I try to not use the same base things all the time or the same blushes and highlights, but this is really hard, and like every time I have done my makeup without recording, I'm like, yes, now I can use them because I really like them. And I see this more as a face palette than eyeshadow palette right now. And I've done it for a while now, but I really love these two. And please, please, Linda Hallberg, start selling your eyeshadows as singles. Another base thing, and this, I don't know if it is a favorite, but I think it is. And that is ColourPop's Precision Brow Pencil. As you may know, I don't like brow pencils, and I started to use this. I don't really know why, because the first time I used it, I didn't like it that much. But now I have used it, I think, the most of October at least. I have used it when I'm going to work, and I like it. I don't feel that I am so good, because I don't feel that my brows are like amazing right now, but I like it, and it is, you screw it up, and yeah. I don't think I will buy it again, but this is like the only brow pencil that I like, and this is in Champagne Blonde, so this has been a favorite. First, I just used it like one time, just for, I found it in my drawer, and then I was like, I think I'm going to keep using this, and I have used it almost every day in October, so I guess this is a favorite. I don't know if I should take the eyeshadow palette now or should we wait? We can take two other eye things. I have found a new favorite eyeshadow brush, And I have had this brush for a long time, I think over a year, and I haven't used it that much. And it's from H&M, and this is their Precision Eye Color Brush. And I love to deepen down my outer corner with this. This is like a really thick, round, dense blending brush. Precision eye coloring brush. I don't think that is that precise, but I really love it to take like in my outer corner and just like deepen it down. Love it for that. And I have deepened down a lot of things in October, so this is really good. And I really like H&M eyeshadow brushes. They are really good. And then a pen. And sometimes, I don't know, it's like, am I a boring person? Have I started to become a neutral makeup person? But then, okay, I'm sitting here with green and blue eyes, so maybe not. But a pen from ColourPop that I really liked is Honey Dude. This is like a nude pen. I don't know how to describe it good. Maybe like you want something, but you don't want color in your wash line. For me, this is the perfect color because it is there, but it's not like, it's not adding anything, but it's not like, it's there, but it's not there. I really like it, and I have had this, I can't remember when I bought the kit, but it's some pens like this that I have never used before, but this is really good. This, I think I could use, like, without any other makeup if I look maybe a little bit red in the eye or tired. This is a really good color for me, so I have really, really loved this pen this month, just to have something there, but it's not like obvious that I have an eyeliner, no wash line, so that's good. And the eyeshadow palette that I have loved in October is Good Sport from ColourPop. I did 3 looks, 1 palette, I can leave it up here, and this is such a good palette. And it has some unique and really cool shades, like Ebb, one of my absolute favorite shadows in my whole collection. And also this Rookie, I haven't like touched it before, but it is really, really good. And also this Licious. I am so happy that I decided to buy this palette. This is absolutely one of my absolute favorites from ColourPop. It doesn't maybe look much like this, but it is an amazing palette, and I am so happy that you voted on 3 looks, 1 palette with this, because I have had such a fun time to play with this, and I want to do more things with this. I just don't know what, but... And then the 2 last things are 2 lippies, and now these are 2 limited edition lippies that are not available anymore, so maybe it is... It always feels a little bit stupid to talk about favorites that I have that is not available anymore, because this is like a little bit of a recommendation, but at the same time, I have had a low buy the whole of this year, and I'm going to do the whole year with a low buy, so I have used more things that is already in my collection than I usually... I think I've bought like 2 lipsticks, okay, 3 lipsticks this year. And that says a lot, because I love to buy lipsticks. So I still want to talk about things that I have like rediscovered in my collection, even though they are limited edition and are not available anymore. But at the same time, it feels a little bit dumb to talk about them, but that is how I look at it. And I'm going to talk about, as I said, 2 lipsticks that are not available anymore, but that I really, really love and have loved this month. So yeah, I'm going to talk about them, and if you don't want to, just fast forward a couple of minutes. So yeah. So one of them is from Nabla, and as you know, I love Nabla's liquid lipstick, and this was in a set with 2 of my absolute favorite colors ever. And this is Blair, and I like remember this to be super light and like light and pink for me, But then I used it in a look and I'm like, this is an amazing color. I don't know why I haven't used it more. Maybe I can swatch it. It looks like this. This is like an amazing color and I haven't like... I was so into Hanging Rock that I like didn't see this in the pulp kit. But this is such a nice color and it's pretty unique for me and my lipstick collection. And I have like rediscovered this in October and it's like, why haven't I used this more? So yeah, this is Blair from Nabla. The other one is from Jeffree Star and this is I'm Shook. And it is the same thing with this one. This was the Manny MUA and Jeffree Star collab and I love the cap on this, the black one. And this has been like, it's a red, but I have like in my mind been like, no, it's too pink. But it's like, it's not too pink. I really love this. I don't know why I haven't used this more. But it's not, in my mind it was so pink, but like, I don't know in what look it was, but I used it and I'm like, have I had this in my collection and don't use it? So during October I have used this a lot and I have used it. I think this is like a very good wearable red, but it's not red, but it's not pink. It's something in between that is so good. So these have been my two favorite lips for October. So yeah, that was all of my October favorites. I really hope you liked this video. And have you had any special favorites during October? And it feels so strange that it is now when I'm recording it, it's now November and I am like, what? And I am soon done with my low buy. And we only have two more favorite videos to go and then I will do a favorites of 2019. It's going to be so hard. And I'm also planning to do a favorite a throwback. Okay, why am I talking about this in this video? I'm going to do a throwback favorites of my favorites of 2018, the end of this year. So it is at least like four more favorite videos. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video. If you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. And I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!